you're trusting your child to this school that has no track record, no history, no experience. That was an enormous leap of faith on their part. These kids were about to launch into what we believed would be a possibility, a school experience, a career path that would put them on a brand new trajectory. That to me was very, very exciting. Just the idea of being able to get them up in an airplane and expand their view of the world, just getting them to see the world as a bigger place, a different place, to get them out of their neighborhood and see the horizons move back and see their own potential in a different way. That was exciting to me, that we were going to be a part of that in their lives and in the lives of students to come.
8 years ago, the seeds for the West Michigan Aviation Academy were planted. 4 years ago, the school opened its doors. Today, the members of the very first graduating class are receiving their diplomas. This is the story of how a visionary charter school came to be, and how it came to change the lives of all these students.
A high school at an airport? Dick DeVos says it's the perfect combination.
This is the kind of school that I would have loved to have had if I was a kid.
Losing a race for governor leaves an empty spot in your schedule. My wife, after a little while, as we talked about, said, you know, this is a wonderful, frankly, opportunity to do some things that we've wanted to do. And it really, credit to my wife, Betsy, for introducing the idea of combining two passions. One was the passion for education reform and education opportunity for kids, especially kids who can't afford the alternatives that many in our communities can afford. And the second was my own personal passion for aviation.
There was a period where I think there were a lot of concerns. Is this school, are we shooting too high in terms of the requirements for the students? And what we're going to be asking even of the parents, but ultimately those fears were unfounded.
And we knew we needed a school leader. If this was going to happen and come together before the fall, we knew we needed a very strong school leader to make it happen. It was clear after the interview I would say it was February was when we interviewed Pat, that he was the person to make this school happen.
I basically said to him after some introductions, you got to be kidding me. This was, I think it was February of 10, a school in August. And I said, why don't you wait a year? And they said, not an option. We're opening in the fall of 2010.
Former East Grand Rapids High School principal Pat Quina has been tapped to run day-to-day operations.
We watch helicopters and airplanes take off and land all day. We have access to the different hangars and to the airport itself. So we're really in a perfect location, a perfect laboratory for our students in the aviation-themed high school.
Pat Quina is an extraordinary leader. He's been a gift to every kid at the West Michigan Aviation Academy.
We started this school on March 1st of 2010. With nothing. I mean absolutely nothing. And we opened school September with 80 kids.
Then they show Mr. Quina and Mr. DeVos saying, come tonight, we have an open house. I call my husband and I said, we are going tonight. When they explain what the dreams they had for the school and for the community, for the children, especially the students, we said we are going to sign up our son, and we did it without even asking him. We just did it right there at that moment.
They painted this picture that says we wanted to be a part of this. We have to be a part of this.
Yeah. Well, once they were saying that we could possibly get flight training with the school, it was like a no-brainer. I wanted to do it.
What parents and grandparents want for kids is universal. They really want them to have opportunity, and they want them to be in a safe place that will be invested in their children.
When we came out for the information night, there wasn't a lot to the school yet, but the fact of the matter is the people that were behind the school, that's really all we needed to see.
It was exciting. It was a really kind of close group. Everyone got to know each other really well, and everyone made friends instantly. So within like the first week, you had like a tight group of friends, and then people would just kind of join the group.
The school was really small the first year, so we got to know everyone really quickly.
When you start a brand new school, you get to pick everything. It's amazing. You get to pick, this is how we're going to grade kids. This is going to be our philosophy behind teaching and learning. And because it's so much more grassroots, it's more effective.
It was so exciting that first day or two to see the students in the classrooms with the teachers at the head of the class, and realizing that education is happening here.
And to have them come in their uniforms, as scared as, I think we are probably more scared than them. But here are these 80 kids, mostly boys, as I said, seven girls, coming from all walks of life. We had white kids and black kids and Hispanic kids. We had boys and a few girls. And we embraced them from the moment they came in the door.
General Colin Powell, a man who has served as the chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff and Secretary of State, prepares to face a tough crowd, the freshman class at the West Michigan Aviation School in Grand Rapids, Michigan.
It doesn't matter where you start in life, it's where you end up and what you do along the way.
What were some like main guidelines and morals you kind of lived by that really got you through all the major accomplishments?
Was trying to live a life of integrity and honesty and ethical behavior.
In Grand Rapids, Teresa Rashid, EHE-TV.
The trip to Washington, D.C. was really cool. It was the first time I'd been on a commercial flight since I was really young, so it was the first one I actually remembered, and I think that was really awesome for Dick DeVos to do that for us, to fly us there.
It's an exciting morning at the Gerald R. Ford Airport. We have 69 freshman students getting ready to board a plane to head to Washington, D.C.
The entire student body and staff were recently treated to a year-end celebration. The founding family of the school, Dick and Betsy DeVos, generously provided a free trip for the entire school.
It just brought our class together, the senior class together more. And it also taught us more, like there's more options out in the world than just aviation and all. From the D.C. trips, you could go into politics for aviation.
My favorite part was seeing the inside of the B-17 bomber. It was just seeing the cockpit. Like, I don't think that I would, like, in real life would ever, like, be able to see, like, how it looked like when it was originally made.
It was awesome, especially when you get up to the Air and Space Museum and Mr. DeVos is just standing there.
It was really, it's really fun to personally be able to see the kids arrive here at the Smithsonian and their eyes as big as saucers looking around Washington, for most of them the first time in our nation's capital, for many of them first time commercial airliner.
It has been an amazing day with the students of the West Michigan Aviation Academy here in Washington, D.C. Did you guys have a great time? Yeah!
And aviation is a unique discipline, because I could tell any student here that the sky doesn't care how much money your parents have, doesn't care what your house looks like, doesn't care what street you live on, doesn't care who your friends are, doesn't care what kind of clothes you wear, doesn't care what race, color, creed you are. It only makes one unswavering demand on you. It's a very strict demand that you must accept the consequences of your actions. When you go to the sky, if you're not prepared, you're going to have a problem. If you are prepared, you're going to get a reward.
I've taken the private pilot class here and then advanced flight and instrument flight here, and I'm the only female to go through that all the way. And so it's really fun and interesting, and it prepares me a lot for all the things that I'm going to have to learn, because I know a lot more than anybody else who would want to be at my age.
I can't believe as a sophomore that I get to fly. Like, it being up there and I'm controlling it and I'm only 15, most people, like 25, don't get to do that.
They are a very special class, being that they are the first ones. Not having children of my own, I always call these kids my kids.
I just watch some of the things that the students are doing, even when they're flying remote control planes, and I think we didn't have a vision for that, but look what they're doing. I mean, it's just so encouraging to see all the things these students have accomplished here. I'm so proud to be a part of this.
They come to us because they want a great education in a safe environment, in a school that really cares about each child. We try to communicate all of those values. So if they do nothing in life related to engineering or aviation, but go on to do great things somewhere else, I'm grateful. I think we've been an enormous success.
Our kids have been a part of something, I think, so special, and that they're going to go off and do tremendous things.
My name is Celeste Blackmore, and next year I'm going to SMAT, which is the School of Missionary Aviation Technology.
My name is Moses Curia, and next year after high school I'm thinking about joining the military.
Hi, my name is Jack Lennon, and I'm looking at colleges where I would be able to double major in dancing, but also pick up a classics-related major.
I'm Tyler Vansty. I'm planning on going to Lake Horde on Blue for the culinary chef.
My name is Brian Curry, and I'm going to be going to college for engineering.
Hello, I'm Kurt Troop, and next year I plan on going to Baker of Owosso for auto and diesel tech.
Hi, my name is Matthew Smith, and I would like to go to Western Michigan University next year.
My name is Bailey Wessel, and I'm going to Central Michigan University.
My name is Jack Friesel, and next year I'm going to be attending either Western Michigan or Embry-Riddle.
My name is Casey Townsend, and I will be a Spartan next year.
Hi, my name is Brandon Spencer. I plan to go into aerospace engineering at either U of M or University of Alabama.
My name is Danielle Daves, and I'm going to Grand Valley State University next year.
High above the chimney top, that's where